Hi guys, I'm Shanae Grimes Beach and welcome back to my channel. Today I am switching things up a little bit because I have been struggling with what kind of content to create during this time. I think we're being fed a lot of information, a lot of misinformation every day. And so far the biggest takeaway, we're all the same. You know, this crazy virus doesn't discriminate. I just pray that coming out the other side of this, we're all better people for it, and we all accept and embrace and support one another a whole lot more than we did before this experience. It's so easy to, when you're stuck inside your four walls, get sucked into this black hole of how is this affecting me? How is it affecting the people that are close in my quarantine circle or in my family friends circle or whatever? And it's not healthy and it's not productive. It's not the way we can best be using this time. I think obviously, you know, getting to soak up a lot more of our family is important. Obviously, they're also gonna drive you nuts. That's not what this video is about. I think the most productive, proactive, positive thing we can really be doing with this time is helping each other in any way, shape, or form that we can by whatever means we have available to us at this time. We have been in this for, I don't even know what day it is. It could be day 3, it could be day 21, and it could be day 1543. It all feels the same. I'm rambling. That's what I do. I've got a lot of thoughts going on in my head, and whenever I turn on this camera, all of a sudden they just start pouring out of my mouth. So my apologies, but you got time. You can watch this video. It might run a little long, but I know you got time right now. Basically, the point of this video is to share, I think I came up with like 10 really easy ways that you can help to support one another and help each other get through this. And hopefully we will all come out that, I mean, we will all come out that other side, but hopefully we come out the other side better for sharing this experience. So the first thing you can do is gonna sound really redundant, but I can't emphasize this enough, stay home. If you are fortunate enough to be in a position where you have the luxury of staying in the safety of your home and not spreading it, not catching it and all the rest of it, then just do that. It's really, really simple to do. When this first started, we were doing our part to stay home, but we would still go out to grocery stores and still do pharmacy runs and things like that. And to be honest, I don't think we were making enough of an effort to stay home. I think we were letting a lot of opportunities to stay home slide because we were probably itching to get out of the house, to be honest. And also because we just weren't thinking and taking it that seriously. Now we are, and we really are not leaving our house. We take the dog for walks, make sure Bowie gets outside. And when we do so, we make sure that we do it very, very carefully. We never come in contact with other people. We wear masks and all the rest of it. But I wanted to suggest a couple things that we've started to implement in our life. If these are options that are available to you and affordable for you, then they're great options to just make sure that you are staying at home as much as physically possible. And those include meal kit deliveries and grocery deliveries. None of this is sponsored, by the way. These are just things that I'm genuinely a customer of now, and I'm really happy that I am during this time. So I use HelloFresh. I wish I had a discount code to give you guys. Unfortunately, I don't, because like I said, this isn't sponsored, but I'm sure you can find discount codes online from other influencers. I've been using HelloFresh since actually before all of this quarantine thing happened, and I just love it so much because the meals are delicious and it's really simple, really straightforward. They deliver X amount of meals to you, or X amount of meals ingredients to you every week, and it shows up on your doorstep and it's all super fresh, and you're just gonna have delicious meals for the week. There's a ton of meal delivery kits, by the way, so if you're not into HelloFresh or whatever, there's a bunch of other ones as well. And then we've also been using a company called Farm Fresh to You. And what they do is they work with local farms, most of them are family run farms, and they get fresh produce delivered to your doorstep again every week. You can customize these boxes or you can just leave them as is and kind of take what comes your way. Produce is like the one thing obviously that is very, very perishable. So to have the option to not have to go out to the grocery store is If you follow me on Instagram, you probably saw my feed post about this a few days ago. My husband is actually working with a company. It's called Modern American. They basically have a local LA-based factory and wanted to do whatever they could to meet the needs of people right now. They wanted to put their resources to use and create masks because obviously there is a massive need for masks right now. You've been trying to find a mask for you or your family. Obviously, it's probably been very, very hard. We couldn't for ages. So when Josh's friend approached him and was like, I have a factory, I think I need to start making masks because nobody can get them and we have the resources to facilitate that happening. We were like, amazing. For every package that is sold of the mask, the same amount of masks is going to be donated to those who really need them most. That is our frontline workers. That is our essential workers. That includes, but is not limited to, obviously the doctors and nurses and hospital staff, but also bank tellers, grocery store staff, pharmacy staff, delivery drivers. There are all kinds of people out there who, as I said earlier, do not have the luxury of staying home right now. And those are the people who need these masks most. So when you purchase your own mask and your family's masks, you will know that you're also helping provide masks for the people who need them the most. It's beautiful, it's brilliant, it's super freaking easy. You can click the link in my video description below or go to iammodernamerican.com and you can purchase masks, protect yourself, and protect your neighbor. The third thing you can do is find ways to take care of yourself with self-care that are also helping those in need. I got an email this morning from a brand called Tula. I really love their skincare. They do great masks, great exfoliators. They sent me an email this morning saying they're doing their part to help doctors and nurses, specifically all of the medical staff who are in need of N95 masks. These people are in small spaces in those hospitals working face to face with people who 100% have coronavirus. That's who needs these N95 masks. If you have any, go and donate them to a hospital right now. Stop watching this video, get out the door, get in your car and go donate those. The way that they're doing this is they put one of their masks on sale, 50% off. So now it's only $20 for a package versus 40 originally. And 100% of the proceeds of this face mask, it's like a sheet mask, it's all hydrating and brightening and all that good stuff. It's just a nice little treat yourself moment at home. And 100% of the money you spend on those masks will be going to the doctors and nurses who need help the most. I'm sure there are other beauty brands out there who are doing this kind of thing, so look for it. If you're online shopping and you're trying to find makeup or skincare or little things that you can do to take care of yourself and treat yourself while you're stuck in quarantine, then just keep an eye out for brands that are selling specific products and donating the proceeds to these important causes right now. Number four, in Los Angeles, I was made aware of this from the church I go to actually. They work hand in hand with a homeless shelter that is about to open their doors officially, their own shelter doors, to I think they have 80 beds or something like that to the homeless population in my area. But they have just gotten clearance and approval from the government here, from the mayor's office, to open temporary shelters at four different locations. This means that they're taking over public rec centers and they are turning them into camps, and they need supplies, they need clothing, they need snacks, non-perishable snacks, they need instant coffee, they need hand sanitizer, antibacterial soap, toilet paper, all that kind of stuff. Everyone's being told to stay at home. Well, homeless people don't have a home to go to, and those people need to be taken care of. And to the amazing people who are running these little pop-up homeless shelters all over the city, I'm sure it's happening in your city as well, they need your support. So it's really easy to do no contact donation drop-offs. Just contact the shelter, contact the city, and find out how you can donate things. I know you're wearing sweatpants all the time right now, but I'm sure you can spare a few pairs of sweats and spare it for somebody who is in much greater need than you are. Get to your closet, go and do that, and then you can come back and watch the rest of this video. Number five is support small local businesses. I hope that you've heard this a million times already. If you haven't, then I hope your ears just perked up, because all of those small local businesses that we get our coffee at and we love to order in at or go for date night at or whatever, go work out at, those places need our help right now. Their doors have been closed or their business is extremely limited due to people not eating out, not really wanting to get takeout, et cetera, et cetera. So the way you can support these local businesses is obviously by ordering takeout, if that's something that you're comfortable with. Obviously you should sanitize the bag and the boxes and all that stuff. If you're getting takeout, then tip big, guys. Tip the delivery driver big, because he is literally risking his life to put food on the table for his family and put food on your table too. So please be generous with your tips during this time. You can also just buy gift cards. If you're not comfortable getting takeout, then buy gift cards to local businesses so that when life goes back to normal, which it will, hopefully those businesses will be in a position to open their doors again and you will be able to redeem those gift cards, no problems asked, but it's gonna keep their business afloat and make sure that their doors can open again. One of our friends has a local boutique gym that my husband goes to 3 times a week, and obviously his gym had to close, so he's actually turned his business into a virtual one for the time being. He's got a workout app. He does live workouts every day on a YouTube channel that he just started. There's a lot of people getting very creative about how to turn their small business online. So please just look it up and see what you can do to help support them. If you're sitting around with time on your hands and wondering, gosh, I need to feel productive. I need to feel like I can make a difference. I need to feel like I'm using this time to create a positive impact. You can. You can volunteer virtually. You can stay in your PJs and help people from your couch. Why wouldn't you want to do that? A few organizations that are worth mentioning because they really stood out to me when I was looking up ways to volunteer myself are the Crisis Text Line. This is a 24-hour text line. You will be vetted. Obviously, there's an application process, but it's a 24-hour service to those with mental health issues who just need a friend, need support, need help to get through whatever they're going through right now. Mental health is a major issue for a lot of people on a good day. During this time, I'm sure they're getting an influx of texts, so they need an influx of volunteers. Another volunteer opportunity I found out about recently is called Be Your Eyes, and it basically matches volunteers with blind people who need help with everyday tasks. So you get put on a video call or a phone call with them, and you guys obviously chat. Great company for both of you. Who doesn't love that right now? And you just help them with things like reading the label of a package, things that they would otherwise struggle with day to day due to their visual impairment, and you can basically be their eyes for them, hence the name of the organization. Clever, right? If you don't know what you want to do, you don't know what virtual volunteer opportunities there are out there, then I definitely recommend volunteermatch.com. That's somewhere that I have gone to in the past for volunteer opportunities. You put in the things that you're interested in, the hours that you're available, et cetera, and you'll get emails with different opportunities of organizations that are in need of your help. Obviously, it goes without saying that money is a great way to help people. Volunteering your dollars to their cause is super important. I know that's not realistic and feasible for everybody right now, so that's why I mentioned this second. But obviously, if you have money that you are in a position that you are able to donate, there's a lot of different companies in need. A smaller financial token that would go a long way is also just calling your local first responders offices and seeing if you can buy them dinner tonight. Just a gesture to let them know that we appreciate everything that they are doing. We are endlessly grateful that they are on the front lines of this thing, out there facing this head on every day for our sake. So yeah, if you can order a few pizzas for your local police office or whatever, what have you, then why not? I cannot remember what number I'm on, and who cares? Because the more ways that we can help each other during this time, the merrier. Another great way that you can do that is by asking your neighbor, check in with your neighbor. Are they okay? Do they need anything? Maybe the next time you go on an essentials run, you can limit them having to go to the shop as well and just pick up their groceries for them. If you're already doing an essentials run, maybe you can pick up some extras and leave it outside of your front door for the delivery guy. A little goes a long way. I love the idea of leaving something on your front step so it's contact free. If you want to check in with your neighbors but you don't have their number, then just leave your phone number on a little piece of paper and leave it on their front step or in their mailbox or something like that. My husband and I did that as soon as this thing started. We made sure that we had the phone numbers of all of the neighbors in our area, made sure that we put it out there. If they need anything at all, please do not hesitate to reach out. And it's amazing how quickly this sense of community can grow when really you've lived next to these people for years and not interacted much beyond a wave or a smile. So it's amazing to feel like you have the support of your physical community as an emotional support community as well. well. Just a couple more things and I'm done. I swear, I know this video is running really long, but I'm just so passionate about this right now because I have been in a slump and this has been helping me, and I hope it helps you help other people, and just, it's gonna be one big happy circle of helping. That leads me to my next point. Check in with yourself and check in with others. I think it's really important to check in with ourselves right now. I know personally, my head has been spinning. I've suffered with anxiety my whole life and this has just shot it through the roof. Checking in with myself has been really important. I actually try to wake up every morning at 5:30, even though I got nowhere to be, just so that I have that hour to myself in the morning and I can kind of think and be. By the time my daughter and husband are awake, I'm feeling a little more centered in my skin. Some days it doesn't make a difference and some days it really does. So check in with yourself, let yourself be okay or not okay or wherever you're at today, and give yourself and each other a whole lot of grace right now. And check in with other people. Just asking somebody else right now, like, how you doing? Makes a huge difference to their day, I guarantee you. That leads me to my last thing, which is be accountable and hold others accountable right now. I think when our routines have been thrown out the window and no one knows what day it is and all the rest of it, it's so easy to stop holding yourself accountable. I think it's okay to have flexibility in that routine right now because everything is different and it will all go back to normal eventually. So soak it up to a certain extent. Be flexible, be easy on yourself, go with wherever you're at today, but I think it's still important to hold ourselves accountable. I know that I have felt myself slacking across the board. I haven't been filming any content because I feel like I have nothing that is worth saying right now, nothing worth watching right now. And that's held me back. And I think it's silly because this community right here on YouTube is one that I value so much. And I think I need to be there and be present for the people who enjoy watching my channel. I've definitely let myself slide on eating right, on working out. And I think having somebody else offer to hold me accountable for something yesterday made me want to do the same for you. I basically had a friend call me just to check in on how I was doing. Meant a lot. It was really nice to hear from them. We chatted for a while. She was like, you know, I did this thing. It's like a 21-day challenge. It's like a meditation thing about abundance and gratitude. So it was like, I'm gonna send you a text message every day and it's gonna be like this new thing that you need to sit with and think about, and there's a little homework, whatever. I love that she is willing to commit that time to me of every day. She's gonna hold me accountable for something that will ultimately better myself. I want to do the same for you. A lot of people enjoy watching my home workout videos. I've been working out at home for a year and a half and loving it. I've gotten into the best shape of my life from my home workouts. And so I want to challenge you. I'm holding us both accountable here. This is a challenge for me too, because like I said, I've been slacking recently. I want to challenge you to do a 15-minute workout every day. You can sign up at the link in my video description below to receive emails from me every day for the next 21 days. That's until April 30th, which is what the government is currently saying is our last day of quarantine. I don't know if that date is gonna stick, but until then, for the next 21 days, I'm gonna be sending you an email every day with a 15-minute no equipment workout. 15 minutes, anybody can handle it, no equipment, so there's no excuses. Basically, just click the link below because I want us to all walk out of this experience feeling more fit and strong and healthy and good about ourselves than we went into it feeling. And I think we can do this if we do it together. If you sign up, please share videos of you participating in this challenge on your stories, on Instagram, whatever, tag me wherever so I can be your cheerleader and cheer you on. Make sure you challenge other friends of yours to take part in this as well. Send them the link of where to sign up, and for 21 days, every single day, you will get an email from me, I promise. I appreciate you so much for taking the time to watch my content, and I really hope you enjoy it. So leave me a comment below with what other content you want to see from me during this time. I know with, you know, Miley Cyrus doing a talk show right now and interviewing Selena Gomez, there's a lot of great shit to watch. Stay safe.